I have some very important news. It appears that the most important scientific discovery in the field of geology during the last 20 years was just made, and it is so incredible that if it were to be proven as true, could save millions of lives due to a common geologic hazard, earthquakes. As a new scientific paper published by Q. Bletery and J.M. Nocquet found what could be described as the first instance of a consistent signal or pattern being found before every large magnitude earthquake they looked at. Specifically, a change in GPS sensors was documented to precede all 90 magnitude 7 or larger earthquakes which were analyzed. To put in simple terms, they analyzed the preceding 48 hours before each major earthquake occurred by looking at GPS sensors which are commonly placed on significant fault lines. For the first 46 hours, there was nothing interesting. Yet, across all of them, something strange began occurring during the last 110-minute window before the major earthquake struck. Whereas normally the fault lines would not move a noticeable amount during this period, in this narrow window before a major earthquake occurred, the faults all trended in a single direction for 22 data points in a row along the orientation it would eventually slip, with one data point being taken every 5 minutes, and reached a value at least 1.82 times as large as the maximum data range in the preceding 46 hours. To make sure this wasn't a fake signal, as sometimes if you look hard enough you can quote-unquote find a pattern which does not actually exist, they looked at 100,000 other 48-hour datasets which did not precede a major earthquake. They found that the pattern just described only occurred as a false positive in 30 of these examples. To put this data into context to show what it could mean, I present California's famed and feared San Andreas Fault. The southern section of this major fault line produces a significant earthquake about once every 140 years. Although we have no clue what the magnitude of its next major earthquake will be, let's hypothetically say it was to be a magnitude 7.7, which would be likely to cause tens of billions of dollars in damage. And let us assume that the pattern this paper discusses occurs before every single magnitude 7 or larger earthquake. Then, if there were sufficient GPS sensors on the entire length of the fault, during an average 140-year period, one actual signal would be detected preceding a major earthquake, along with an average of 7 to 8 false positives. That is pretty great. Hypothetically, people could be told for each of these 110-minute windows to simply move to a safe area which can withstand a possible earthquake, possibly in a field far away from where large objects could fall. This might be the future for those who live in major earthquake-prone areas. But, supposing this data is correct, it presents two major problems. One, it would be quite expensive. High-precision GPS sensors are not cheap, and many more of them would be required to create good coverage on major fault lines. Two, while current GPS sensors are highly accurate, they are not yet accurate enough to be decisively used to identify such insignificant and minute movements of a fault preceding a major earthquake. In other words, to make this work, we need an improvement to GPS technology which has not yet occurred. I want to remind my audience that this apparent major discovery has not yet been confirmed. It needs to be repeated by numerous other scientists who can look at their data and through their own analysis repeat the results or not. There are currently numerous possible alternative explanations for this apparent trend in the 110 minutes before a major earthquake occurs, which could be simply explained by foreshocks, small sample size as only a pool of 90 earthquakes were used, or even other variables which have yet to be identified. In other words, while the discovery could be groundbreaking, the findings could still be incorrect, and the possibility remains that no such pattern actually exists before a large earthquake strikes. And if the findings are correct, the technology potentially does not yet exist to allow a real-world implementation. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank my new patron, Jane Mundale, for supporting this channel.